This is a picture in page number 232 of your chapter. In this picture, various roles of the government are shown. Okay, the first is, the first level is the union or the central government. So at the higher level, or you can say at the first level, is the union or the central government. This is the government at the center and it makes major decision of governance for the entire country. So what is the role of the central government? The role of the central government is they will make major decision so that they can run the entire country in a better way. Okay. For governance, the country is divided into small territories called state. So in order to look after the whole country, our country is divided into small territories which are generally known as states. Each state has its own government. So every state, they have their own government. This is the second level of government. So states are the second level of government. First is union or central government. The state government look after the welfare of a particular state. So the state government duty is to look after the welfare of a particular state. That means they will look after whether in their particular state all the people are happy or not. Okay, they will make different rules and regulation so that the people can live peacefully. People living in villages, town and cities form their own government to look after their local needs. So even at the village, towns and cities level, they make their own government so that they can look after their basic needs. This is the government at the third level and is also called the local self-government. So these level of government which are established in the villages, town and cities, they are known as third level, and the other name of the third level is local self-government. So we can say that our India is divided into three parts, and thus we have the three-tier system of government in our country. First is union or central government, second state government, and the third is local self-government. Levels of government. In a huge country like India, it is not possible for a single government to efficiently govern the entire country. So our India is a very huge country, right? And it is not possible for a single government, that means the central government, to look after the whole entire country in a better way. So the government performs at various level. Each level has its own set of responsibilities. So it is not possible for the central government to look after the entire country like India, right? So that's why the government is divided into various level, and each levels have their own responsibilities which are written in our Indian constitution. We will learn about the working of all the levels of government in detail in subsequent chapters. For the sake of governance, the country is divided into states and union territories. So about the levels of government, we will discuss further, okay, in the further chapters. And in order to run the government, or in order to make a peaceful environment in our country is divided into various states and union territories so that the Indian government can govern or look after the needs and requirement of the citizen of our country. Next, laws and the government. One of the main function of the government is to make law. So one of the main function of a government is they will make laws for the country. All the people living in a country have to abide by the law. So all the people who are living in any country, they have to follow these law. Okay, that means they have to implement in their day-to-day life. Why are laws important? Laws are important because they ensure that people live in a peaceful and regulated manner. So why laws are important? Because they make sure that all the people are living in a peaceful manner and in a systematic manner. Let us take an example. On the road, people have to follow some rules. Obeying the traffic signals, having a control over speed, crossing the road via the zebra crossing, etc. What happens when people do not abide by these laws, or when the traffic light do not work at a busy intersection? There is much chaos and lawlessness. So now we will understand the why law is important with the example. Just like in the traffic signal, or you can say on the road, right? People have to follow certain rules and regulations so that the people who are riding the car, bikes and so on, they do not face any problem. And the rules such as obeying the traffic rules, having a control over our speed while driving, we should always focus on the speed, okay, and we should cross the road via the zebra crossing. For example, if all these laws are not followed by the people, the situation will be worse and there will be lots of accident which will take place, and thus there will be and the system will be very chaos and lawlessness. That's why law is very important, so that we can live in a healthy and a peaceful way. It is important that we follow rules in all spheres of life to avoid chaos and unpleasantness. So in order to make our life more peaceful and more you can say healthy and more you can say satisfaction, we should follow this law. Also, when all the citizens follow the same rules, they are liable to similar punishment if they break the rule. If all the people living in a country, if they follow the same rules, so similarly the punishment will be same if they break any law. Everybody is equal in the eyes of law, and there is lesser chance of discrimination. So in our India, everybody is equal in the eyes of law, and there is total, or you can say there is no chance of discrimination in our country. That's why these laws are made.